Hi everyone, my name is Kanishka and I'm a part of Azure Identity and Authentication team at Microsoft. In this video, let's discuss about how to get user activity reports and the last sign-in reports from Azure AD using MS Graph PowerShell module. Now let's just start with understanding what is Microsoft Graph PowerShell SDK. It is an API wrapper for Microsoft Graph APIs that exposes the entire API set for use in PowerShell. It will help administer every Azure AD feature that has an API in Microsoft Graph. For Microsoft Graph PowerShell SDK installation, using the install module commandlet is the preferred installation method. We can run the install module command to install the SDK in PowerShell Core or Windows PowerShell. After the installation is complete, you can verify the install version with the get install module command. The PowerShell SDK supports two types of authentication: app-only access and delegated access. App-only access grants permission directly to an application and requires an administrator to consent to the required permission scopes. You can also use delegated access to sign in as a user, grant consent to the SDK to act on your behalf, and call the Microsoft Graph. Use the connect MG Graph command to sign in with the required scopes. In this example, we have used user.read.all, group-read-write.all, and audit-log.read.all. It is important to note that we need to have audit-log.read.all permission in order to access the sign in logs for the user. Now let's just start by giving a small demo on how we can install the Microsoft Graph PowerShell module and how we can fetch the user activity reports. Let's just start by first installing the Microsoft Graph PowerShell module. This command successfully installs the Microsoft Graph PowerShell module. After the PowerShell module is installed, we can verify the installed version using the get install module command. We can also use the connect MG Graph command to connect and sign in with the required scopes. After it has successfully signed in, it will show us a message saying, "Welcome to Microsoft Graph." Now let's move on and understand how do we fetch the user activity reports. The user's last successful sign-in time provides potential insight into the user's continued need for access to Microsoft resources. As an IT administrator, you want to detect and handle obsolete or inactive user accounts. The Microsoft Graph SDK now supports the resource type sign-in activity and exposes the last sign-in date time property, which shows the last time a user made a successful interactive sign-in to Azure AD. Below are the two commands that can help us fetch the sign-in information for users. The first command gives a user last sign-in using Microsoft PowerShell commandlet. This will give the sign-in information about a particular user. The second command will help us to fetch all the sign-ins from the audit logs for all the users. Now let's start by retrieving the Azure AD user sign-ins for our tenant. The command import module will import the Microsoft Graph reports module. And post that, when we run the get MG audit log sign-in, it will fetch all the sign-ins for our tenant. Let's just run this command. As you can see, it fetches all the sign-in for our tenant. Similarly, we can get the information about a particular user's last sign-in. Here, in this command, we will find out the last sign-in information about a particular user whose GUID is mentioned as part of the command. Important thing to note is that the sign-in activity is part of the beta version of Microsoft Graph SDK. we will have to change our Microsoft Graph profile to beta before executing this command. Now, once we run this command, you see that the output is the last sign-in information about that particular user. Below are the two commands that demonstrate two examples on how we can fetch the sign-in information based on the different conditions. The first one is the command to retrieve the first 10 sign-ins to an app where the app display name starts with Microsoft Graph. The second command retrieves a list of inactive users which have not accessed Azure AD in the past 90 days. As an example, we can also retrieve the first 10 sign-ins to apps with the app display name that starts with Graph. When we run this command, it's going to give top 10 results of the sign-ins where the app name starts with Graph. One of an important use cases for accessing the user activity reports is finding out the inactive users which have not accessed anything from Azure AD for the past 90 days. Just as we have seen before, this feature also exists as part of the beta profile. Hence, we will need to change the profile to beta before running this command. Now, when we run this command, it's going to give us the sign-in information of the users which have not accessed in the past 90 days. As the name suggests, paging means handling multiple pages of results if the response is too large for one request or if the page size is hard-coded by Microsoft. For example, if you want to query all the users in an Azure AD tenant, and that tenant has around 10,000 users, it wouldn't make sense to return all these objects in a single request. Also, as per our official documentation, the default and the maximum page sizes are 100 and 999 user objects respectively. Because Microsoft Graph uses the OData for their REST API, we can also specify the page size by including the top filter. Below is a small script that can be used to keep requesting the next page until we have received all the pages and the objects of a particular query. That's all for today's video. I hope this video was useful in understanding how to fetch the user activity reports using Microsoft Graph PowerShell SDK. Thank you for watching.